Hi guys, Chris here. So I have something interesting today. This is a 15.6 inch IPS panel that is anti-glare, so has a matte coating on it, but it also supports touch. And a very interesting panel because it's light, it's portable, it is powered by Type-C, it has a Type-C input, it also has 2x1W speakers on here, and even HDMI in. So this can be used with a lot of different devices. It can be used with PCs, MacBooks, and it can even be used with, for example, PlayStation 4s, and even the camera that I'm recording on, I could be using a portable screen like this. So this one here is from Vinpok. It's called the Split. Let's check it out in greater detail.
Inside the box, you have the screen by itself, and I'll just check the weight of that. It's 548 grams. And of course you get then the Type-C to USB cable that you're going to need to power it with some devices. You get a mini HDMI cable and then the Type-C to Type-C cable that you'll be using to connect with most PCs and with mobile phones. I've also picked up the magnetic case, which I highly recommend. It's a thin case that covers it and also acts as a stand. And that puts the total travel weight at 1.03 kilos. So there's nothing on the back of the screen here. It has this carbon-like fiber design to it, but it's not carbon fiber. The case just sits on the back there with magnets. And you can fold it around like that to completely protect the screen. And this is still reasonably light, and it's thin too, just under 10 millimeters. And getting started is easy. Just simply open it up, flip it around, and it has a magnet in the top here, so that's going to hold it there, and this is your kickstand for it. So similar to the way tablets are set up, and that's about the maximum angle, right about there. You can get it back a little bit further. It has rubber here, so it's going to grip onto a table, and you can press against that without it suddenly just collapsing too, which is good. On the left hand side we have the power on standby button. Right here we have the controller little joystick, so this is up and down, and it presses in. And that's to control the on-screen display, which I will get onto later on, the on-screen menu there. And we have the Type-C port in. So this is needed to power it. If your device does not output enough from the Type-C port on the right-hand side, then you have to use this to power the screen. It supports power delivery 2 spec, so it's going to run off 5 volts right up to 20 volts. And on the right is where all your inputs are. So we have a micro HDMI 1.4 spec port. There we have the Type-C port. This one supports data, video in, and charging as well, which is really good. So it will output charge to keep your mobile phone, your tablet, or your laptop charged at the same time, which is great. And then a 3.5 millimeter headphone port here, which is great for perhaps, say, Mac users that are lacking ports there. You don't need an additional dongle because you can output the sound through that. Along the bottom, you will find either side 2 rubber feet and this tiny little slot here. That is in fact a speaker. So we've got 2 1-watt speakers down here. I'll give you a sample of them now. They're not amazing sounding, but they do actually sound a little bit better than some of the tablets in tech I review. So the calibration of the screen on the standard preset is actually very good. Only the whites are slightly off, just leaning a little bit towards the blue side there. It's now more of a neutral white once I've calibrated it. But for most people, out of the box, calibration is actually quite good. And normally you don't see this. With some manufacturers, it can be completely off. So it's great to see that they have it properly calibrated. One area that is disappointing, however, is the color gamut coverage. So they do claim that it has 89% sRGB, but with my testing here and with the panel that I have on my unit, I'm only getting 63% of sRGB color gamut coverage here. And Adobe RGB, this is 47%, NTSC is 45%. So the brightness on my panel doesn't come up to spec, their claim. So they claim around 280 lux, and this one here is only about 160 lux, which is well short. I do have it on 100% brightness, which by the way is actually the default brightness you can see. So 100 right here, it's always set on 100. You can tone that down, of course, using the little controller there. So the screen is touch, and if you're using a USB Type-C, USB 3.1 device, which I'm using at the moment, which is the Jumper EasyBook X1, then I have touch. Now, Windows already has the driver for this, so you just plug it in, and it will install the driver, and you can see right now touch is working. Now, it has 10 touch points, The screen supports that. I have tested this and it does work well. Sometimes I have to tap again. Now that could be because I'm not on the most powerful chipset. That might have something to do with this. So you can see here like scrolling and things like that with Windows. That's all working well. The start menu. And all in all, it acts like a normal touch screen would. So this is probably just a little bit slower because I'm not running the most powerful chipset. I'm only running 4 gigabytes of RAM here, but it's just to demonstrate that it's gonna run fine on even low powered hardware like this. So the only real issue here with me, with the screen, the brightness could definitely be a bit better, but indoors, it's perfectly fine indoors. It looks great, and I like the fact that it is matte coated as well and not glossy. So you don't have any problems with the reflections, and it's a typical IPS. So the viewing angles, they are perfectly fine. You're not gonna have any issues with that being an IPS panel. One of the main reasons for getting a screen like this would be what I'm doing right now. So you've got dual displays and it's a lot easier to then multitask. You can be a lot more productive doing this. Now I've got touch support on both of these devices here, and of course it's gonna be working just fine. As you can see right there. Now, if your device doesn't have a Type-C port, then you will still have touch with Windows. You just need to plug in the Type-C cable to the port right here on the right-hand side, and then once the drivers load, it's touch, and you plug in, of course, the HDMI cable onto the right-hand side as I showed you at the start. This, of course, right here is where the power goes into it with that Type-C port. So it depends on what cables you have, how you're gonna set it up, and you'll be able to run this with touch. And you can even connect it up to things like the Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4, Xbox, anything really, and just run it as a standalone HDMI portable display then. And you can then use a portable power bank to power the screen, or you can just plug it into an adapter. So you can have a power adapter going to Type-C. So it's gonna run 5 volts right up to 20 volts there, and it does support power delivery, that Type-C as mentioned. Another use too is you can use this as a screen for your mobile phone that supports, if it does, desktop mode. So for example, right here I have my Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus. I've plugged in the Type-C to Type-C cable. Normally when you're traveling, you will have your charger as well. So you plug that into the other end to power the screen, because the phone by itself will not actually be, doesn't have enough wattage, the output from the Type-C port, to power it, but it's working. And even touch, which surprised me. I thought touch might not work. And it actually does run pretty good, as you can see. And if you get yourself a Bluetooth keyboard and even a Bluetooth mouse, pair that up, of course, with your phone, and you've got yourself then a laptop that you can use when you're traveling. And because it's such a thin and relatively light screen too, you're not carrying around that extra bulk. If you wanted to do some emails and do some proper work and whatnot through this, then that is all possible. As you can see here, I've just loaded up my website, TechTablets. I'm able to add articles. It does have a file manager too, of course, with Android and the phone. And if you've got a Huawei, the Mate 20, you've got the P20, P20 Pro, Mate 20X, it's all gonna be working as well with this. So the touch support with that one should also work. I think it's just a standard Android drive that it's using to power the screen here. So this gives you a little bit of added productivity with your phone. And it's hard to see, but right down there, you can see it is charging my mobile phone as well. So when I'm using my Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus here with DeX, it's gonna be charged at the same time. So I'm not losing any battery, which is great. So the on-screen display, your controls here for the panel, it's pretty straightforward here. You can control the brightness, contrast, black levels. You've got different other things that you can tweak in here as well, your colors. So the one that I always go for, this is the user one. That's the one I have measured. And right now you've just got some settings here for the actual menu itself. So you can set the transparency of it and to time it out. A few other settings here, even an HDR mode. And this right here is quite handy. So we've got a blue light filter on here. So if you're using this late at night, you just press in, by the way, with a button to actually make it work. And you can start to tweak that up. You can see it's removing now the blue light. So Vinpok here, the Split, is a very practical screen. There's so much you can do with this screen. Of course, you can run it with anything that has a display out, and it's via HDMI. So you can run your PS4, a Nintendo Split. You can even use this as a large monitor screen for your camera, for example. Like the camera I'm recording on, I could have the HDMI going out into this to use it as a monitor there to have a look and see if everything's in focus, and you're able to do that. So it's got many uses. It's going to work with Mac OS. It works with Samsung DeX, your Huawei phones, other phones that support HDMI out, and the desktop mode, which is really great. So you could perhaps chuck this, throw this into a bag, and have your phone there. And if you bring along a Bluetooth keyboard and a mouse, then you can use it like a laptop, like a touch laptop or even tablet, and it just makes it quite practical. Yes, you're going to have the cable there. Now, most people would be carrying around their Type-C charger with them, so that's not too much of an issue that you can plug it in. I would like to see a version perhaps with a battery on there that you could at least get a few hours of battery use, so you didn't have to bring another cable if you didn't happen to have one with you. But I don't think it's too much of an issue because it keeps it slimmer. You're not going to have any problems in the future, of course, with batteries going bad and things like that. What I would really like to see, more than a battery, is I believe that it would be great to have on this a USB port. So one USB port along here means that I will be able to plug in a pen drive or something when I have it connected up to my phone and access that. Perhaps plug in a Logitech wireless receiver for my keyboard for my mouse would make this even more practical. Hopefully in the next version they can add that. So the screen is great. It's good for indoor use, but it doesn't have the same color gamut that they claim. So they claim that it has an sRGB of 89%, and it's nowhere near that, coming out around about 63%. The brightness as well, it tops out at around about 160 lux on my unit. I've got it turned down to about 50% brightness at the moment, you can see here. And indoors, it's perfectly fine, and even in sunlight, you're still going to be able to read it. So that's not really too much of an issue. However, if you are a professional, you're going to be using this as a portable second monitor on your laptop, you're doing color work, then I don't know, is that 64% sRGB color gamut coverage going to be enough for you? Now, this is selling for around about 200 US, and I do believe that you can get various different uses out of it. So the price, I think, is justified considering out there on the market, there is really nothing like this. And I've been looking for a long time for a Type-C portable screen with these kind of features, but also the nice modern look with the slim bezels. So all in all, it does get a thumbs up from me. I do like it. It's not perfect, and hopefully that Vinpok, they can add a USB port and perhaps give us just a slightly better panel in this in the future, one that's more closer to their claimed spec. Thanks a lot for watching this review. I hope you did like it, and if you did like it, then please subscribe to the channel, and I do hope to see you back with more up-and-coming reviews. Bye for now.